Deep beneath the surface of our world, something primordial is moving. It shifts in silence, unseen, unstoppable, but shaping mountains, swallowing cities, and rewriting coastlines. For centuries, it has created and destroyed, waiting in the shadows beneath the sea. We live above it, we build upon it, and forget it's there, until it reminds us. Scientists have tried to understand it. Civilizations have fallen because of it, and one day soon, it will rise again. What lies beneath may be Earth's greatest power and its greatest warning. This is the Earth's most dangerous secret, the Ring of Fire, the ring that doesn't shine with gold, but with fire. It is the Earth's most dangerous place. The Pacific isn't as peaceful as its name suggests. This is where most of the planet's volcanoes and earthquakes are born. The Pacific Ring of Fire is one of the most extraordinary and dangerous regions in our planet. It forms a vast horseshoe-shaped belt around the Pacific Ocean, stretching from New Zealand and Indonesia up through Japan and Alaska, then down the coast of the Americas, all the way to Chile. Covering over 40,000 kilometers, it contains about 75% of the world's active volcanoes and produces nearly 90% of all earthquakes. But what makes this region so volatile? The answer lies in plate tectonics, the theory that the Earth's outer shell or crust is made up of massive slabs called tectonic plates. These plates are made up of solid rocks which fit together like pieces of giant puzzle. But they are constant in motion, slowly drifting over the molten layer just below it called the mantle. Where these plates collide, slide past one another, or pull apart, the planet's energy is released. When one plate is forced beneath another through a process called subduction, where intense heat and pressure melt parts of the sinking rock deep within the earth. That molten rock is called magma, which comprises of a mixture of molten minerals, gases, and crystals found beneath the surface. This magma slowly rises through the cracks in the crust. When it finally reaches the surface, it erupts as lava, creating volcanoes, islands, and mountain ranges. But this process also stores tremendous amount of energy. When that energy is suddenly released, it triggers earthquakes, tsunamis, and massive eruptions, events capable of reshaping entire regions within minutes. In the Ring of Fire, life and destruction are inseparable, both born from the same fiery forces beneath the surface. In 1883, the eruption of Krakatoa in Indonesia sent shockwaves across the globe. Its explosion was so loud that it was heard 5,000 kilometers away. In 1980, Mount St. Helens in the United States erupted violently, destroying forests and reshaping the mountains itself. In 2011, the Tohoku earthquake of Japan triggered a devastating tsunami, claiming thousands of lives and altering the landscape forever. There are many such events that have changed the course of civilization. These are not isolated events. These are reminders that beneath our feet lies a force beyond our control or comprehension. Scientists agree that the Ring of Fire is far from dormant. Pressure continues to build deep beneath its fault lines. In North America, the Cascadian subduction zone stretches from Northern California to Canada could unleash a mega thrust earthquake capable of devastating the Pacific Northwest. In Japan, tectonic stress continues to accumulate along the Nankai Trough, where another major earthquake is expected within this century. Indonesia, home to more than hundreds of active volcanoes, faces constant risk of large-scale eruptions that could alter global climatic conditions. Along the South American coast, the Nazca Plate is steadily pushing beneath the continent, storing energy that one day will be released in a massive quake. These are not possibilities. They are inevitable cycles of a living planet. Scientists can track them, they can model them and issue warnings, but they cannot stop them. As technology advances, early warning systems are improving. Seismographs, satellite imaging, and deep sea sensors now allow scientists to detect subtle shifts in tectonic movements before disaster strikes. Recent research has pushed these tools even further. A study at University of Ottawa used seismic imaging to map hidden processes in subduction zones. Another breakthrough at University of Texas at Austin introduced a deformation imaging technique that used only surface GPS data to reveal a deep magma reservoir beneath part of the Ring of Fire. These advances mean that we are no longer just responding to disaster, we are beginning to see them in motion. But even with the best technology, nature's timetable remains out of our hands. Awareness and preparation can mean the difference between survival and catastrophe. Yet, the ultimate truth remains. The planet will always move on its own terms. The Pacific Ring of Fire is not just a zone of danger. It is the planet's heartbeat. It creates new land, sustains ecosystems, and fuels the dynamic nature of Earth itself. Without it, the world would be geologically silent, lifeless, and still. But with its power comes the risk. It reminds us that Earth is not static or tame, but alive. A planet is in constant transformation. And though we have learned to predict and prepare, we can never truly control it. When the ground shakes again and the sea roars back onto the shore, humanity will be reminded of one simple truth, that the earth remembers and its fire will always rise again. And in that moment, we will know not only the might of nature, but the power of the Creator who sets this world in motion. If this video opened your eyes to the power and mystery of our planet, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. It truly helps us create more stories like this. Tell us in the comments what topics you'd like us to research and make a video on next. This video is available with subtitles in more than 30 languages, so people anywhere can learn together and understand the world we all share. Thank you for watching, and as always, keep exploring with your heart. Till the next time, signing off.